Hello, and welcome to Tom Myers versus the rest of the world. A lot's been going on. Donald Trump has started his own cryptocurrency platform. Among his employees are his children, including his son, Barron, who at 18 years of age is listed on the company as a visionary. Visionary at 18? When my friends and I were 18, the only ones who were considered visionary were the ones who took ketamine and DMT. It was discovered that Michigan Senate candidate Mike Rogers was registered to vote at an address which is a property that can't legally be classified as a residence. According to his neighbors, the home is not yet complete and still has to be inspected to make sure it's safe for the purposes of residing there, thus making the dwelling more structurally sound than those of his supporters. Michael Flynn, Trump's former national security advisor, spoke at a public gathering and said that a lot of people are agreeing with him that Trump needs to return to the White House. I don't think he realizes that people agree with him in the same way that one would agree with a mental patient before they give him his medication. During a campaign stop, Colorado Congresswoman Lauren Boebert participated in an event where she had to run a gauntlet that featured spectators wielding pool noodles. Come on, everyone. She likes to grip things harder than that. Marjorie Taylor Greene said her staff were attacked when leaving the Capitol because D.C. is a violent city. No, Marge, they're attacking them because they know they work for you. The National Weather Service announced its winter storm names this week. Of course, they weren't published at the time of this recording, but ultimately it doesn't matter what the names are, as the reactions to the storms will be, God damn it, aw shit, and the classic, fuck this. Mountain Dew has announced it's changing its packaging for 2025. It's a shame they can't change the flavoring to make it more drinkable and taste less like rednecks, sad gamers, and hangovers. And now, on with the show. Please join me in welcoming Chipp Jones, Polite Kitty, Tiffany Norton, and Walter Gottlieb.
Yay. Hello, Tom.
Welcome back, everyone. So what's everyone been up to this week?
Not much. But did you hear that Jimmy Carter finally got his vote in? I'm so excited for him.
I wonder who he voted for.
At least we know we have one down.
What if he voted as an independent? He's like, you know what? I've always wanted to. It's my last hurrah. Awesome.
Dr. Stein.
Yeah, he just writes in Jill Stein. Yep. Yep. Everybody's like, ah, Jimmy, you fooler.
Should have wrote himself in.
Oh, he's such a nut. Get it?
He only had one term. He can go for a second one.
That's true.
Good point.
You know, Carter disclosed this week that he used to be Biden's babysitter.
Oh, wow.
What?
I thought that was Methuselah's job.
Yeah, Methuselah's 900, Biden's 878. You asked how the week was. I gave myself a news blackout because I couldn't take the election roller coaster. You know, it's a dead heat everywhere. Half the country's lost its mind. I had to take a break from CNN.
Well, Walter, this ain't CNN, but if you're looking for a break from the news, this is the wrong show to be on. I don't know if you listened to it lately.
I'm refreshed from my news blackout. If
you want a break from the news, just watch Fox.
The ultimate satire.
None but none on that one.
With Election Day drawing closer and balloting already taking place in several states, including my own state of Maryland, where I have already turned in my ballot, the ratcheting up of the presidential campaigns is a natural progression. But it takes a bizarre turn even for Donald Trump, as is evidenced in this footage of the wrapping up of a Pennsylvania town hall.
And we're going to turn this country around. It's the greatest movement in the history of our country, MAGA, Make America Great Again. When Biden would go on, he used to go on. Say, we will stop MAGA. We will stop, you know, remember with the purple background, the pink and purple. He looked like the devil, right? But she's worse than him. Remember it. But they would say, we're going to stop MAGA. They go, MAGA means make America great again. I mean, what are you going to stop? And we are indeed going to make America great again. America has never, we're a declining nation right now. We're a nation in decline. And we're not going to be in decline for long. Let me tell you, every country respected us 4 years ago. We were energy independent. We had everything. We had the greatest economy in the history of our country. We're going to bring it back bigger, better, and stronger than ever before. Go and vote. Yes. Let me hear that music, please.
Everyone, let's thank music. President
loud.
Trump.
Nice and loud.
God bless you. Let's send President Trump back to the White House.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole.
I get that like, a lot of musicians don't want him using their stuff, right. But it's gotten bad to the point where his supporters are starting to look at each other and go, what is this shit?
No, they're going, isn't that an immigrant language? What the hell?
They're going to have to start using AI music. That's it's going to have to all be royalty free.
Oh yeah,
you know like that's yeah, I mean Tom's right, right. Like everybody's that's, like that's, not my music.
That's Barron's thing. He's just going to be sitting there with a garage band on a laptop making music for
that's right.
Well, that's what we mean by visionary.
Yeah, he's the visionary for the AI division. Yeah, I like it because all he's got what is like who's on his side even anymore.
Well,
I don't know. The devil. Lee Greenwood, I think you can still play.
The devil's on his side.
Yeah, no.
The devil who wears pink and purple and blue.
Yeah, Charlie Daniels' band said, actually, no, you can't use that. Devil went down to Georgia.
They did.
And Charlie Daniels is like super conservative, mm-hmm. or he was super conservative. Yeah. So that's just, I'm still speechless. That's astounding.
Yeah, hey, I may be behind the times, but I'm not sure what that music was. It sounds like a MAGA version of Les Mis. Am I off base?
Well, it's from an opera, and I can't place it, but it's a favorite. Isn't it Figaro or something?
It's a big popular one. But like you said, that's what we're down to.
Opera singers and indie bands. Everybody's just going to try to. You know what? He could steal Diddy's idea and have making the band. Ooh.
Maybe Wagner will come back from the dead and say, "Don't use my music."
Oh, that would be great. Just the ghost of Wagner haunting him.
The Walking Dead of Pavarotti.
I think they just changed MAGA to Make America Gag Again. Good God.
Well, speaking of gagging, I mean, you saw who was with him on the stage. That was Kristi Noem.
Oh.
So as soon as I heard that music, I thought to myself, I wonder if she had this playing in the background when she put her dog down and she told Trump about it. And that's what inspired him to use that.
Oh, God, it's just a trauma response.
I feel bad for his promotions team. He's probably just like, play something classy. You know, that was it.
Wasn't there a clip, Tom, where he was dancing to fill time?
Well, you're a white guy, so you might have called it dancing.
I wouldn't call it dancing. And I am a guy guilty on both counts, Mr. Jones.
I mean, he couldn't even dance to the YMCA. He fucked that up. So
he was sort of like one of those balloon guys in front of a used car place. Just kind of,
you're right.
Wherever the wind took him, you know, it's like...
It was like the Elaine dance on Seinfeld. It was just kind of like,
every time he dances, doesn't he look like he's jerking two guys off?
That's Bill Maher. I think Bill Maher has said that every single show this season. He's had that clip up, you know.
Well, it's the only thing Bill Maher's got original. At this point, so just let him have it, you know. But that's the thing, is like, because I noticed the difference. People... gave Biden shit because the Juneteenth celebration on the White House lawn, he was standing there just frozen while everyone else was dancing and they were singing. It was like, no, that's, he was being smart there because he probably thought to himself, okay, Trump looked like a doofus. Right. I'm older than Trump. I'm also a white man. Like, I'm just going to avoid any awkwardness altogether. Right.
He knew he was going to dance to the words, and he just didn't want to show that. You know, just you know, let the people who dance with the rhythm go. I'm just going to stand here.
Hey,
is this loses, what we've come to? Is on, just white dudes swaying?
I'm afraid so. Yeah.
It's been this way for a while. Right. Men don't ask you to dance anymore when you go out. That's at right. all. There, yeah, it is. It's like, would you like to sway with me? That's essentially it.
All right, all right. I feel t-shirts for the market. White dude sway. I think he catch on. I think he catch on.
Now available on the Tom Myers versus the rest of the world merch page.
White dude sway.
I finally have a t-shirt idea that could sell.
That's it, man.
But what do the real Trump supporters on the ground think of the ongoing campaign and the policies of the Republican presidential nominee? CNN caught up with some of the faithful at a boat parade in Florida, as we can see in this clip.
We're at the MAGA boat parade at Shell Island, which I've never been to, so this is my first time coming. We were in the middle of the parade following the lead boat, well decorated with all the flags.
Fight, 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 fight.
There's a contest who can be the most Trumpian, and I want to win first place.
It's a weed eater motor. It's a 21 horsepower. It makes a very frozen mudslide quick.
Trump is pro-American. He loves America, for one. I love America. I serve this country. I love America. We're from the same place in Queens, New York, so that's my homie.
I live in Latitude Margaritaville.
What's your most important issue?
The economy, getting the interest rates down, getting it to where we can afford to live in America. Right now, it's too expensive.
Okay, now, let me maybe ask like a slightly impolite question. But, you know, if you can afford a boat, you're not hurting so bad, right? Because a boat costs a lot of money and it's a lot of upkeep.
Listen, nobody gave me shit. I earned everything that I've got. I'm retired military, retired power plant, and I am successful and retired and with boats, jet skis, because I did it right. And everybody has that chance. Whether they choose or not, that's up to them.
Okay, there is so much to unpack in that video. Like, first of all, like, how lame of a boat party is it if they make you say the Pledge of Allegiance before you get drunk on mudslides?
There you go.
That's, I always do that before I get drunk on mudslides. That's why I don't drink anymore.
Yeah, I usually do it after.
Here's my modest proposal. Can we do a reverse boat lift and like send them all to Cuba or
that's
something?
Right.
Like, I don't think.
Why are you picking on the Cubans? What's up with that?
I know.
Yeah, they don't want them. They've got enough dictators. They're cool.
It's just the reverse. The Cubans are welcome to come here on the boats. I'm just saying, why don't we reverse it and send these that's assholes right. there? Oh, well, you're saying, Chip, why would I want to inflict those people on
exactly.
the people of Cuba? I get it. Okay.
Don't they have enough poverty and stuff already?
Yeah, but they I don't still have like enough the boats.
I still like the black woman from Queens saying, yeah, we're from the same neighborhood.
Oh,
no,
sure.
You're not. Trump wouldn't sell a house to you there. Come on.
Yeah, his dad wouldn't rent you a freaking
that's
apartment.
Right.
There was a whole lawsuit.
No,
about
you're
that.
Not.
I couldn't help but crack up when the guy said, we can't afford to lift. And she's like, excuse me, but you got a boat? And he didn't.
You know, she was so polite about it, too. She was like, excuse me.
Yeah.
I would have been like, bitch, like, your boat is over there.
But he was like, not only does he have a boat, but he has a jet ski. It's like, you know, it's like a third house, you know, it's like, you know.
Yeah, I have a tiny house. Okay, I have a tiny third house and a tiny, tiny yacht. That's it. That's it. That's you know it. What? But I worked for it.
I'm scraping the barrel here.
No one gave me shit.
Tim
it's like,
worked
well,
for it, and her boat is the size of a thimble, right?
That's right. I'm scraping the bottom of the barrel for caviar. You know, it's like, I'm almost out.
Tom,
that took your dick for caviar.
That video was
that's
truly
a party.
Right. Truly frightening.
Well, yeah. and I will say mad props to the guy, like, you know, serving his country and whatnot. And you know, you can't, you know, deny him that. But it's sure. it's like nobody gave me shit. Like, your pension and benefits are our tax dollars. So yeah we are kind of giving you something in return. And like, how about you be a little, you know, appreciative?
So are your roads and bridges and Coast Guard, bitch.
There you go.
if I titled episodes, that would be the name of it. Roads and Bridges and Coast Guards, bitch. Would do wonders for the algorithm.
Oh my.
Well, and to your point too, Tom, like, I mean, he's such the, obviously we talk a lot about a lot of stuff on this podcast, but it's such an ableist perspective. I worked for it. I did this. I did that. Well, some people can't go into the military. If you're colorblind, you can't go. That's not your fault. You know, so some of these things, people go, well, you can always go to the military. The military does not take everybody. Right. If you have attention deficit disorder, if you're on any kind of medication, any of that kind of stuff, they're not probably taking you. So it frustrates me. Yes, you know, it's a tremendous sacrifice. Don't get me wrong. But
Right.
You could even have bone spurs and avoid the military.
That's right.
Yeah, they wouldn't even let him in. He wanted to fight too. He was like, just put me on the front lines, man. Put me in, coach.
Some of the people are kids who grew up in Flint, Michigan, have been drinking lead for the last 5 years. So yeah.
They had their chance to leave. Right, Chipp? Damn it.
They make cars right there. Just take one and
come
go.
On. Oh. Didn't you ever see Andy Griffith with Opie? You know, tied the little handkerchief around the stick and ran away from home. They could have done it.
They had many options.
I know.
They could have slept on that guy's boat.
That's right.
That's true.
Are you kidding? If Trump was Opie, then Andy Griffith would be like, son, go back there and fetch me a switch.
That's right.
Get you behind the woodshed.
But I love that the guy too, did you notice that he lives at Margaritaville?
Yeah.
Which is a real community you can live in, and you can pretend to be Jimmy Buffett, or one particular song that Jimmy Buffett wrote for the rest of your retirement.
Good God.
It's just alcoholics paradise.
My sentiments, Walter. God.
Thank you, polite kitty.
I'm like, we have an alcoholics paradise right around the corner for me. It's called Fell's Point. Like, we don't need to go down to Florida.
Anybody know why God hates Florida this time in North Carolina?
I think we just saw it.
I don't think it's God. I think it's Neptune. Whoever's in charge of the sea.
The water in the harbor is not quite as clear as in Margaritaville, is it, Tom?
That's right.
No, it is. People are starting to swim in it. And, you know, thankfully the mutant transformations will only take place in about 10 years instead of 5.
That's it.
To appeal to women voters in the wake of the Dobbs decision, where the Supreme Court overturned the protections guaranteed by Roe versus Wade, former First Lady Melania Trump makes her pitch as to why women would fare better under a second term of her husband. As we can see in this campaign video, courtesy of her social media.
Individual freedom is a fundamental principle that I safeguard. Without a doubt, there is no room for compromise when it comes to this essential right that all women possess from birth. Individual freedom. What does my body, my choice really mean?
Marlena by Fabergé.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably like, it's not a good idea, like, to go ahead and try to appeal to voters with an ad that's automatically going to make them turn away because they think, oh fuck, it's another perfume ad.
She's dead. That's AI. Something has happened to her. She hasn't been in the country, I don't think, for 4 years. Yeah. And yeah, no, that's AI. Did you see how the mouth looks and everything? Yeah. I mean, it.
Are you sure it's AI and not just Jim Henson with his hand up her ass?
It could be, yeah.
Am I the only one who couldn't understand a single word he was saying? Good God. That reminded me less of the perfume commercials and more like the Apple 1984 Orwellian thing. Somebody to lob something at the screen.
Hey, come on, Walter. You're old enough to remember. That's more like Cheech and Chong. You will not sign the paper. Sign the paper. Will not sign the paper.
Are you saying Melania had a little toke before the shoot?
That's right. Mm. Oh, he put the cigarette out of his eye, man. Ooh, he will not sign the paper.
Right. She uses those classified documents from in the bathroom and she rolls up.
People were, I guess, now I sound like Trump. People were saying, a lot of people were saying that she did that just to help soften his image, and other people were saying that she directly contradicted her husband. Which do we think it is?
Well, she's planning. She's planning for both outcomes. Is right. What I believe.
She's planning. She's planning her own coup.
She's going to see which way this plays out. You know, I know she's got an NDA. I also know she's got probably a pretty great prenup. So let's just, you know, she's like, I don't want to violate the NDA because if it doesn't work out, I really want to be able to get the maximum amount.
They did say that the positive that came out of that video was that it encouraged people who are, you know, underneath the thumb of an abuser who votes conservative, that you can vote whatever way you want when you're at the polls. Yeah. But that's the only positive that came out of it.
I still think she's probably really angry because, I mean, I imagine she lost a lot of money on two assassins that didn't work out. That's money down the drain.
I don't think the first kid would be someone Melania would hire. First of all, the outfit. No.
No. I can't believe that for once I'm not the most offensive one on this show.
That is a red letter day.
You should have had a bell to ring for me. So, ding, ding, ding.
We have a winner.
Yes, yes.
I'm just glad I'm not the one coming up with conspiracy theories today. Usually it's me.
Well, I came up with one too, because Melania, that's not real. She's AI now.
She's AI.
I think she's actually been AI for a while. She might have been the first AI.
She's vacationing on a beach somewhere going, those fools.
Tiff, you're saying that they brought her back from the dead like Livia Soprano or something? Like,
oh, I don't. I think that, you know, well, I'm not so sure she wasn't originally made of plastic. So, you know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. I don't know where the timelines cross, but it really struck me just looking at the mouth. And it just really looks like, because now they're showing like on AI, like these AI generated videos, and they're freaky, but it's the mouth where you can kind of tell it's not real. And that's, I don't know.
Implant. It's a whole person is silicone.
Right. Well, I think she substituted herself. She substituted a sex robot for herself when Trump originally ordered her. I think.
Yeah. I want her makeup artist though. Real talk. I want to be AI.
I was just thinking the same thing, Tiff. I was like, you know, the makeup's on point. I will say
that. It would be nice to just throw on an AI face, you know, when you're running late. Just wear one of them out. Like, who do I want to be today? What do I want to look like today? Oh, good. I'll be Melania. Why not?
That's right. Nobody gave me shit. I earned this position on the Tom Myers show.
That's right. I got a small inheritance, and that was it.
That's it.
Of course, Trump supporters are no less gullible than anyone else, as we can see in this trolling effort on TikTok.
My sweet Trump! Ooh, my Trump! I really want to feel you! Really want to fly with you! want to fly with you on the Jeffrey Epstein plane, my Trump. I want to fly on the Lolita Express with Trump. I want to put ketchup on his ear. It was ketchup. We all know that, right? Put ketchup on his ear. No, I'm going all day. Ketchup on his ear. Don't touch me. That's assault. And yeah, with underage girls with Trump.
Get the fuck out of here.
Freedom of speech, brother. Remember, no political violence. I want to get on the Lolita Express with Trump. Hell yeah.
No more. Don't say that.
Well, where's everybody going? We'll be here all day. Trump wants to date his daughter.
That may be the best use of the song My Sweet Lord by George Harrison that I've ever seen.
Yeah,
we need to have him come out with an album.
Yeah, George is spinning around in his grave, but it's out of joy.
That guy looks like the perfect age to have had a Mr. Microphone. This has been his moment. He's been training for this for some time.
Man. The crowd was starting to sway like Trump, and then the lyrics changed. They're like, wait a minute.
How brave do you have to be to do what that guy did?
I feel used. I danced it to it just a little.
I mean, he seems as psychotic as the rest of that crowd legitimately were, which is probably why they didn't beat the crap out of him at first. Like, they're probably afraid that he was gonna, like, if you're making Trump supporters go, okay, this guy's nuts, let's walk away, you have succeeded in doing something that the rest of us have been trying to do for nearly 10 years.
It was the adult version of Gotcha Nose.
I love how he worked into the lyrics, don't touch me, that's assault.
Yeah, exactly. Remember, no political violence.
And jazz hands.
which is exactly what George Harrison was trying to sing about in that song. Like, no violence. None of that.
Hurry.
I just want to make sure that guy got to his car okay. I mean, is there a follow-up TikTok? You know, it cut off abruptly. So
you think that guy has a car? I'd say it's more like a unicycle.
Although, it's like, I think, like, anybody who would see him there would probably be like, let's just leave this guy alone. Yeah, we this is the kind of neighborhood where we can roll anybody we want for their valuables. Let's just leave him alone. All right.
Well, when you wear the Trump pair, you know, the outfits, and he was dressed in the group, he was probably there socializing for quite a while, right? And so, and he's got the bullhorn and everything like that. So I'm sure when he sprung the lyrics on him, they were like, man, I shared a bottle of water with you, traitor.
I gave you my Trump bra.
Yeah.
Come on, you know it wasn't water, it was beer. Come on.
Yeah.
I mean, if he has the guts to sing like that, then it had to have been something other than
water.
But I like that theory, Tiffany, that you think it was like some kind of, you know, undercover operation, like Chris Maloney in Law and Order: Organized Crime, like that. he worked for an entire 6 months.
Yep.
And that was his culminating moment, just a less than 30-second moment on TikTok. Played on the show.
He was the white version of the Black Klansman. That's what he was.
Yeah.
He was the Adam Driver character. Yeah. He was actually being operated by another, by you, wasn't it, Chip? Morton, he's the guy.
That's it.
Calling the shots.
And on that note, that's our show. I want to thank Chip Jones, Polite Kitty, Tiffany Norton, and Walter Gottlieb.
Yay.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you.
Thank you, buddy.
This episode was written and hosted by Tom Myers with panelists Chip Jones, Polite Kitty, Tiffany Norton, and Walter Gottlieb. Theme music composed and arranged by Jeroen Vandenhurk. Executive producers Tom Myers, Matt Connarton for ipmNation, and Eddie Carson for Odyssey Radio. Please leave a 5-star rating and a positive review on Apple Podcasts. And don't forget to subscribe to the Patreon, patreon.com/TomMyers, for access to ad-free episodes, extended episodes, and bonus clips. Thank you for listening, and please visit tommyers.us.